everybody, it's Pembroke W. Corgi, and I'm here with...
Kirio!
And Kiyo Kusagani, 1996, or 98, depending on what channel you're watching.
And we're going to play Xenophobe, and possibly other Aliens-inspired games, depending on how long this takes. This game only has 8 levels, and then it repeats, so it might be short. So, let's see. Unfortunately...
So the characters are a guy, an alien, and a duck.
Yep, and it's not letting me pick the characters for some reason. Okay.
You need to use the left and right buttons to switch your character.
I tried that. See, let me just check the inputs real quick. See here.
Of course I don't have to tell you guys how influential Aliens is as a franchise, even as early as 1985.
Yeah,
I haven't seen much of that myself, but then I'm not much of a horror person.
They shifted focus over to action for the second Aliens movie, and that worked well in its favor because there was more than one of the bastards that time around.
Yeah, the second movie is definitely far more just a straight-up action movie. Wow, that's weird. It's still, like, not letting me select the character. Well, I guess I'm this character. I wanted to be the duck, damn it. I'm going to try that again.
I believe in you to be your right to be the duck.
Alright, so.
Quack!
Oh, I see now, yeah. So, let me see. There we go. No! Wait! No! One more time.
Add it and you did it wrong again.
You selected Captain Sulu, everybody's favorite red shirt.
Alright.
So. Captain what?
Sulu. Sulu, go to warp!
I don't think Sulu was ever a red shirt.
Well, like, no, that... No, he was blue. What? This game is going to drive me nuts. All right. I think I know what I did wrong. All right. I'm good.
Okay.
We'll get the... I also like that it's not just a duck, but his name is Dr. Quack, which is like a double pun. There we go.
Isn't there a Dr. Quack in ukulele?
Probably. But... It's quack because
I don't
know,
think it's better.
No, it's quack because he's a duck, and it's quack because you know that's the name of a bad doctor. So
wait, the whole game is like done in this very small screen.
Yeah, because it's usually made to like I was gonna mention that later, earlier. It's because it's set to like usually have 3 players, but unfortunately there's
they each get a separate screen.
Yep.
This is actually one of the first games to feature split screens for all 3 players in an arcade game.
Seems a bit restricted for movement and combat, but looks pretty neat otherwise.
There we go.
And this is one of the rare arcade games that I have not heard of before Pemmy started streaming. I knew the basic premise of it, and it was made by Midway, but otherwise, this is actually my first time seeing this in action.
You know what I find? I'm weaker that he has a duck head, but his but judging by this color of his arms, it looks like he has a normal human body otherwise.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of weird.
Which makes
they were probably intending on using the same technology that they used in the Journey game, where you could take a photo of your face and put it in the game, but they ultimately didn't use that because people would flash their butts at the camera when the photo was taken.
Yeah, I don't think that would have really worked since this is like a sprite game. It's not the sort you could just digitize, put a photograph on.
I think it was more just a way to like make it easier so they could use the same body and just the same body.
Yeah, I understand that. Just figured if it was gonna be a duck, it would have used to look a little like it was from Star Fox or something.
There's all sorts of references to popular science fiction in this game, so this game is a homage to everything that was popular at that time.
Yeah, though the alien designs is definitely inspired by the Aliens movies.
It's the bastard child of Star Wars, Star Trek, and Xenomorphs.
Hey, what happens if that self-destruct timer hits 0?
We'll leave and we don't get a bonus, because the idea is you're trying to get rid of all of the Xenons before it self destructs.
Kind of amusing that you're trying to escape a ship that's about to explode and you're crawling on your knees the whole way through.
Oh, I can get off. I can actually stand up if I want to. It's just,
I know. It's still amusing that you can choose to do this the whole way through.
And this guy predated Link doing the duck walk by an entire decade. Eat that, Zelda CDI.
Okay.
Yep, that's true. I can do the duck walk.
Cool, huh? As badly aged as this game is, the cutscenes are never going to age as long as YouTube exists.
Ah, damn it. I wasn't able to save the station.
I mean, they're aged. They're just in us. That's so whatever. It's just that... They were never good. Just people just get fascinated with bad enough stuff.
Well, yeah. Well, it's because memes.
I'm just saying. When something that never ages... that's usually taken to mean it's quality.
I think pretty much what Keo means is they won't be forgotten.
Precisely. It's pretty hard to forget Link's eyes leaving his body and him looking completely soulless.
Oh, why'd you stop the game?
Something was blocking the chat, and I was just trying to take care of it real quick.
Kind of think of it, you probably not a good idea to try to escape on your knees the whole way through.
If you really want to speed up the stages, you can actually find the self-destruct disc and move to the next level sooner.
You can afford to get on your feet a little more.
Generally makes it harder for enemies to attack me. But
yeah, it's actually generally better to be crouching.
What about when there are no enemies?
Well, that's true. That's a fair point.
Yeah, that's the strategy in this game. You stand up when there's no enemies, but most of the time you want to be crouching in this game. At least that's what it looks like.
Yeah, because like those tentacles can get you if you're at the top can get you if you're. Oh shit! Motherfucking.
Ow.
Alien
Drax
queen
asked us
shit.
An important question: is this Duck Game 2?
Wouldn't that be more like Duck Game 0 because this came before that?
The raccoon has a point, you know, Drax. Anyway, Midway was a really interesting company, and they still continue to fascinate me even though their glory days are long gone. They pretty much did whatever the hell they wanted to do, regardless of their monetization practices, and they didn't care what kind of reception they got. Which ultimately led to the video game industry recognizing adult-themed games as legitimate rather than something that kids needed protection from.
And see, they're also probably one of the longer-lasting as far as American arcade manufacturers are related. Because, I mean, they ended up outliving both Williams and Atari Games and owning pretty much most of their... buying them out for the most part.
Why are you...
Which is why there was a Midway copyright on the home ports of Gauntlet Legacy.
Yep.
One of my favorite Midway games of all time, by the way.
You know what? It was kind of neat Ow.
I'm out of weapons. I lost my weapons, so now I'm just punching the shit out of everything.
If you continue, you don't get weapons back?
Well, no, one of the aliens knocked it out of my hand before I died.
You know what, since this whole level's on a timer, why isn't the timer on this just on the screen at all times? It's like... they had space for button inputs, but they couldn't take the spare,
I think that was the point, Kelsey, because you could argue that it adds tension to how fast you're going to clear the level if you don't see your time limit.
Yeah, but that's still... I don't know. Is that what the intent was, or was it just like an easy excuse to add some more fake difficulty to dozen more quarters? Like, you think you're doing well, then, surprise, self-destruct.
Well, the self-destruct doesn't kill you. It just means you don't get a bonus. So that actually doesn't affect it.
Yeah, sometimes you want to intentionally self-destruct by finding the disc in order to end particularly painful levels.
Yeah, so you... Oops, that was not what I wanted. So yeah, the self-destruct isn't going to make you have to put another quarter in. It just means you won't get a bonus for exterminating the Xenos.
Just saying, that's usually not... That sort of hiding the timer and a time level is usually frowned upon.
It is definitely not the best of decisions. Wow, I'm doing...
Speaking of poor decisions, I can definitely tell you one thing. You should not be able to keep your score on continue, which Midway loved to do back then, so your score is meaningless if you can't tell that somebody used to continue.
It's not a bit fair to say it's meaningless if you actually did the work.
I can see both points on that one, so I'll just say that.
Yeah. If doing a no continue run is a stickler for you, you can always just consciously choose to not insert a coin.
Yeah, but you didn't know any better back in the day, though. But with Capcom games and every Japanese developed game, you usually get the one of shame or the equivalent on your single score digit.
Hey, you're outside and you don't need a helmet to breathe.
What? You're a duck. You're a space duck. You can breathe in space.
I can.
Or either that, or you're playing as Howard the Duck, and Howard the Duck is just too angry to need to breathe at all. He wastes all of his breath arguing and ranting instead.
Dang it, I need a gun.
Gun equals fun.
Oh, there we go. And I got a health bonus, which is good, because I am already close to dying again. I used to be good at this game, but granted, the last time I played it, I think I was very young.
Now, Drax, if I were the referee, I would have reinstated Silly Mitchell's records. So I am obviously not the referee.
Silly what?
Silly Mitchell.
Billy Mitchell, he was, he cheated his way to, like, being the, best, Donkey Kong player at one point.
Oh.
Nice. I just blew up the big one. That's actually not easy in this game, so...
Oh, this actually looks pretty cool! Is this the hatchery?
Dang it. Another base overrun with Xenos.
I thought you were killing them all.
I didn't kill enough.
You have to kill every single one of them in order to prevent it from blowing up.
Oh.
Which is difficult to do if you're one player only.
Yeah, it's easier with multiplayers. Or if you're playing the NES version.
Oh, I get it. It's split screen, so you guys can be in different rooms.
Yeah.
Yep. So I have to give this game props for at least that. It was one of the earliest games to encourage cooperative play, and Midway pioneered that as well. I think the earliest one they ever made was Timber, which was 1983, before the crash.
Yeah, that one. I always thought that game was a sequel to Tapper for some reason.
I don't blame you, because they have the same mascot character.
The bartender decided to take up lumberjacking.
Yes! The player character looks very similar, so...
That was the mascot that Midway used for their games way back when, Kells. So he appeared in multiple different games. Domino Man also appears in the game Domino Man, fittingly enough.
You need to reuse a character design and make one up for every game.
Also, when I was really young and before, you know, Mario was in, like, before Mario had, like, really been officially named, like, been, like, the big, before Super Mario Brothers came out.
He was, like, a general sort of, he didn't have much of a defined anything before the Mushroom Kingdom was a thing.
Yeah.
Yep.
So
basically an Italian-American, and that was all he had going for him.
Yeah, so I actually thought that, like, the guy from Tapper and Timber was also Mario.
That's an easy mistake to make. I don't blame your kid mind for doing that, because I got all sorts of
weird
things.
Well, we know, the Tapper guy is also named Mario, but is completely unrelated to Mario Bros. Mario.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, hello, Dalek from Doctor Who. Midway saw that one, too.
I think Midway... there was a Doctor Who pinball game that I wonder if Midway was the one who made that. It was probably Williams.
It was Williams.
Feels like there's a Doctor Who just about everything by now.
Well, that was before Doctor Who was, like, super huge in the States. It used to just be, like...
Go ahead.
I was just going to say, it used to be this thing that people would just watch on PBS.
Yeah.
And that's when being into a show like that socially counted against you. But now it is a religion in and of itself that mainstream people watch and enjoy just as much as we did back then.
Well, it was a cultural phenomenon even in or even way back in Britain. But it hit a bit of a slump, I think, around the 7th the Doctor. But like mid 2000s, it got a popular revival from starting from the 9th Doctor onward, and It's been in its revival again ever since.
Yep.
The 10th Doctor is absolutely lovely. Or if we were in Britain, we'd say absolutely smashing.
Let's see.
Some might.
I'd face a toast to that. Let's have some tea. What?
I feel like any British watchers would get... I don't know how any British watchers would react to that.
Telly is secretly cringing.
I don't think Doctor Who's gotten a whole lot in the way of video games, so I think that's partly due to the fact, like, from what I know, that the Doctor's a pacifist, and it's a little hard to come up with a adventurous gameplay that also doesn't have any sort of violence.
Actually, that's exactly what they did. They usually make point-and-click adventure games out of Doctor Who, one of which you can actually play for free if you have a VPN.
I do know that Lego Dimensions, while it was a thing, had Doctor Who crossing over.
Yep.
And there were even, like, and you could even have Lego versions of all 12 Doctors at the time. Yep. This is a pre-Jodie Whittaker, so 13 isn't in it.
That was a novel take on the toys-to-life genre, since you actually had to build constructs rather than just putting characters on the portal, like every other toys-to-life game.
The Lego games are actually really pretty impressive overall. Like, they're well made, and they're a heck of a lot of fun, and they incorporate all the toy elements, which is really neat.
Yeah. They're good casual games, and I respect that for what it is. It's not my thing, but they're very well made, and they capture the storylines of what they're representing very well while adding humor to them. So it gets 2 thumbs up in my book.
It's definitely better than most...
Technically 2 clawed hand things up.
they're definitely impressive compared to most games that are just out to sell toys. So I'll say that.
And there were a lot of games made to sell toys back in this decade. Shit, I still gotta play a Thundercats Commodore Amiga game. That's gonna be an experience.
I heard that thing was garbage.
You gotta love the early days of British shovelware.
Well, from what I also heard, if I remember right, I think it wasn't even meant to be a Thundercats game originally, but it was just... they got the license and shoved it on something that was already being made.
Eventually, we did get a proper Thundercats game on the Nintendo DS, based on my favorite series, nonetheless, the reboot.
Oh, that was the good reboot?
Yeah, the good reboot. We don't talk about the other one, Pemmy. We don't.
The good reboot that got completely screwed over by Cartoon Network?
Yeah. But, go freaking figure, huh? Yeah. On a similar note, did He-Man ever get any video games?
Yes. Oh, you betcha!
He-Man
actually got quite a few games on the Atari and ColecoVision.
Yeah, didn't he also get, like, a weird, what was it, a weird kind of, like, what was it,
A text adventure? Because
yes, thank
you. Played the He-Man text adventure.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
That's the one where I kissed Merman in that game, and then he arrested me afterwards.
As well he should have.
That was a totally appropriate thing to do at that moment in time.
I'm gonna punch you to death, you monster. I do love that this duck is so tough he can actually punch aliens to death. Oh shit, yeah, we got the good laser.
I wonder...
Oh, we're down to 46%. We might actually pull it off this time.
Oh, you dumped a lot of money into the game now. Now you're fully decked out.
Wow. So much health.
This is like at around the time when Gauntlet was popular, so you could just you know, bribe your way to victory by adding more coins into the machine. So I think you can see my gripe with that now.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it doesn't affect the other good things that this game does.
I think if it's purely like, if at the worst, it affects your position in the high score table. It's not that big a deal compared to say if you're bribing your way to victory in a multiplayer game or something.
Or if you're Billy Mitchell, but.
Silly Mitchell. Correction. Yeah, this is my first time seeing this game, and I gotta say, it's not bad.
No, it's really fun when you can get like three people on it too. But
I wouldn't doubt that for a second, because this seems like the kind of game that would be more manageable to quarantine these ships if you have more than one person running around in it. You can split up and do tactics like that, which was innovative back then.
Yeah, it seems like the sort of thing that could work well for a modern game, albeit probably one with a less unfortunate title.
And just in case you forgot the name of the game, it bounces up and down to remind you what you're actually playing. You know, just in case somebody stole the arcade marquee and you're left with a blank cabinet. Don't forget, you are playing the Wizard's Castle.
Dang it, open up your eggs.
Oh, you know what? These Sonic motherfuckers are giving you the business. I should have known we would have never let little Timmy make a Sonic OC.
Looks like I'm not going to be able to make the,
Well, we're throwing this spaceship into the Sonic dumpster.
We tried. Base is overrun with Xenos.
It's fascinating discovering old Sonic fan content from the 2000s that seemed to be lost to time.
Is that really a fascinating thing?
Well, probably only for me, Pemmy. Probably.
At least I was able to get two alien skulls.
Oh, I don't know what you're going to do with them.
Maybe you learned to juggle them.
Maybe.
Oh, don't unleash some kind of ancient space curse on yourself now.
Well, I mean, you're already punching aliens. You might as well punch alien ghosts, too.
Now, as we all learned from the Elder Scrolls, it's totally effective to fight a ghost by slicing a sword at it.
Actually, I wonder, is there a way that I'm thinking there might actually be a way to turn off the self-destruct.
You might want to hit P to pause it and then check the dip switches to see if that's an option.
I did it. Destruct off.
Oh, wow, that was simple.
All right.
Cool. That's actually something I didn't know either.
I just remembered it, so it was just like, oh, hey, wait. So there we go. This time we're doing it. We're going to clean this place up.
Hey, at least they picked a better crew for the job rather than Toxie, who dies in water, even though he uses water to clean everything up.
What are you talking about?
Toxic Crusaders.
Yep.
Or Toxic Avenger, which got spun up. Which was a horror comedy movie that got a cartoon adaption, which is Toxic Crusaders.
Back before people had any concept of choosing remotely family-friendly properties to merchandise.
Well, Kelsey, I ought to correct you on that one, because back in the day, every single kid wanted to see masculine adult movies, but obviously their parents wouldn't let them see it one way or another, so what better way to get it into the hands of more people than to make a kid-friendlier cartoon of it? The 80s was a really weird time, and that's the only time it really could have happened in.
I'm not sure what those are, but you know what? You do know what actually started that whole kickoff of everything, right, Keo?
Yep, aliens.
Actually, no. It was Rambo.
Cool, and that was one of my favorite movies of all time, really. Sylvester Stallone's second greatest role.
Because what it was Coleco, the company Coleco, didn't just make the ColecoVision, they also used to make toys. and they took a random chance at making Rambo toys, and you know, they were a huge success.
Huh. It's a kind of neat, but kind of sad in a way, because like the first Blood was like a critique on how people about how the people in authority tend to look down and treat veterans and such, explaining how Rambo kind of went berserk later on. But now Rambo is just more remembered as cool badass gun shooting hero, even though he kind of didn't want to be.
Yeah, the moral of the first movie pretty much got lost as soon as they made the second movie and on.
Yeah.
The second movie actually attempted to do a little bit of the more ambiguity, in the sense that the people that sent him out there wanted to leave him there to die, and that was the moral of the second movie, was to do what you could for your fellow Americans and
right.
not abandon them in their time of need.
Right, but the thing was, in the first movie, Rambo wasn't a hero, really, and in the second movie, he is. So, and
yep.
it kind of went
from
there.
Yeah.
He does redeem himself for his actions in the second movie, and the way they shot the second movie is genuinely still impressive with real pyrotechnics.
Satire and deeper messages tend to be lost to people who just want to be wowed with guns and explosions and punching and such.
Oh, yeah.
And Rambo 2, yeah, Rambo did that the absolute best. And the only other movie that comes close was the Arnold Schwarzenegger movies. Like The Terminator, for example, which had state-of-the-art effects back then as well.
Yeah. Well, yeah, satire does get lost on a lot of people. Ooh, the laser rifle!
Ew.
But, yeah, you're...
It's electrifying!
Kind of surprising in a futuristic society that laser rifle wouldn't be standard. Wait, but come to think of it, maybe they aren't because, wow, that thing has pretty lousy range.
Yeah, but it's also, but it's really strong to make up for it, so...
Yeah, that makes sense.
But yeah, like you said, oftentimes satire does get lost on people. I mean, RoboCop is probably the primest example of that. That was a movie made the satire marketing, the over-marketing of America and 80s action movies.
Action movies.
And it became both one of the best action movies and got a ton of merchandise.
That's because more or less they made that movie way too good in order for it to be satire. And the same thing happened with Jaws and Steven Spielberg, which he regrets actually making the original Jaws too good. That's why Jaws 2 was intentionally dumber, so that people would be able to laugh at it more frequently.
Well, Spielberg had nothing to do with Jaws 2.
I thought later Jaws intentionally were more sucky. I thought it was just like the typical sequelitis.
Yeah, it really is just typical sequelitis, because Spielberg had nothing to do with Jaws 2.
Oh yeah,
obviously I see why.
I don't think he particularly had a huge amount of regret years downward, there was more like fear of sharks, and sharks started becoming more endangered, and that's when the sharks started getting hurt because of all of it, and then
that was legitimately bad. Yes, Cal.
I don't think it's fair to blame the movie for that, though.
Well, I mean,
he had a fear of sharks even before the movie did.
Yeah, I guess it's not like he could have been known for saying Still, I guess it does mean it's a little harder to do effective like beast horror, because you know, since in the real world, animals aren't just like heartless monsters. So
yeah, but here's the thing about that, Kells, is that if you write a tabloid journalism headline that says, you know, shark man-eating machine, you know, killed this person today, that grabs attention on the news headlines, so that didn't exactly help either.
Oi. Give me back my rifle, bitches.
And the same director that worked on RoboCop also did Starship Troopers, which I'm not sure if that movie was out yet. That was 1990s. Yeah, it was not out yet. Sorry about that.
Yeah, sorry. But... which was also meant to be a satire, and I think
that actually did a better job of making sure that people knew it was a satire.
Yet people still missed it. And I don't know about that. I mean, RoboCop literally, like, beat Ed 209 by, like, walking down the stairs. That is a literal scene in RoboCop. He beats the bad guy by just going down the stairs. Because the robot was too big and clunky to go down the stairs.